Have you ever thought about how one of these sanding pads are made, or how one of these wire wheels starts with just one strand of wire? In this video, I get to show you how these are both made. This video is in partnership with Weiler Abrasives. They were kind enough to invite us out so we could shoot this video just for you. I also learned some new things and got to see the new pipelining grinding disc that they just come out with, and I'm excited to share it with y'all. I'll talk more about it at the end of this video. All right, let's go back in time a few weeks and get this show on the road.
Hey, can I help you?
I'm here to learn how it's made.
Come on in.
Thank you. Today, we're here at Weiler Abrasives here in the Poconos of Pennsylvania. Some of you might know it as Wheeler, like I did, and apparently we've been saying it wrong. They've invited us out and they're gonna take us behind the scenes and show us how it's made. All right, we're now in the back. I'm here with David. He's the team lead of the knot department, and I'll just let you kind of start explaining where this all starts.
All right, so what we do is we start with a 56-hole knot plate that looks like this. And then the wire will be fed through these holes and twisted. And it'll come out with a finished product like this. After that's done, it'll be fed through a conveyor belt to the operator, who will take it, put it on a trimmer, and they'll trim it. So it comes out nice and clean. It looks like this after it's trimmed. Once they're done with that, they'll weld side plates onto it. And then they'll have a brush like this with the side plates on the side. And then finally, they'll put a nut into the hole, and they put it into a final assembly press, and it'll come out, the side plates formed on there, nice and tight to hold the knots. And the nut in place. After that's done, they'll put rust veto on the side plate so it doesn't rust. And then that goes into a box. They put the pin in a box and they load it onto a skid, 750 brushes on a skid, which then gets picked up, sent to shipping, and out to the customer.
That's amazing. That's amazing. How many wires are in just one of these?
These are, I think, 22 strands.
22 wires. Just in one of these strands, so times how many other holes there are?
Yeah, 56 holes.
56 holes, that's how many wires just in one wire wheel. That's neat. Well, thank you for showing us that and telling us all about it.
Yep, you're welcome.
Alright, I'm back here in the flat disc area with Corey. He's the team lead in this area, and he's going to explain to us how a flat disc is made.
Our jumbo rolls of cloth come in and we cut them down into 40 millimeter widths. The machine behind me is the one that actually makes the 50544 product, where it loads the backing plate onto the machine, dispenses the glue, and applies the individual flaps to the plate. From there, it gets loaded onto a cart where they get formed and baked in the ovens and ready to be labeled, nutted, and packed.
This is a 7-inch disc like we use a lot out on the roadway. How many of these little squares, how big is the roughneck? How many of these little square sandpapers are on here, do you know?
So this is 100 flaps on this particular disc that we have.
That's neat. I never thought about that, but that's a lot of. I never thought there'd be 100. At the end, we noticed that there was these plates being put in between each one of these discs. What is that plate for? What does that do?
So this is actually called a mold. And what it does is the disc comes off the machine. It flat product. And you can see our finished product has this angle shape to it. So as it's being baked and hardened, it gives these molds give it the angle taper to it. Each one of these stacks will get pressed, compressed, to squeeze the disc. And then they'll get pushed into these blue ovens behind me and baked to cure the epoxy.
So neat. And then packaged up, right?
Yes.
After that?
After it dries? They'll get the label on it.
Okay.
And nutted if it's a nutted product. And then they will get packaged.
And then packaged and out to y'all.
And that's how it's made. I don't know about y'all, but that was very, very neat for me to see. Comment down below and let me know if you were surprised by how many steps there were to making this, or if you had never thought about it at all. I hope you guys learned something. After all, that's my goal on this channel, is to learn something every day. I absolutely learned something. We've seen how the wire wheels are made. I'm also real excited to let you guys know about this new 1/8 grinding disc that Weiler has come out with. I'm super excited about it. Whenever they showed it to me, I was like mind blown, because it strictly says do not alter on it, like no chipping. Grinding discs that we're used to using, you gotta chip them. This one you don't have to chip, and it's made for both grinding the bead and for facing pipe. I learned a lot while I was here. One of the things I learned is that some discs, 1/8 discs, are not made to grind right here, and these are made for both. So I'm real excited. I actually got to try it out while I was here. Works real good. I think it's going to be really beneficial to the industry and the people that are just starting out, especially because it actually does the job like it's supposed to. There's a link to their website in the description below that will have everything you need to know about the new grinder disc if you want to get your hands on them. So go check that out in the description. I'm definitely going to be using it and trying it out in the field and everything, like in real situations, which is something they have done also. But anyway, I'm going to be trying it out. So if there's any videos or that you guys want to see me try or whatever, let me know. We'll get that done. We want to thank Weiler for inviting us out to show us everything. It was very, very cool. So thank you. You can head on over to their socials. Tell them thanks for allowing us to come in and see everything. Tell them what you thought. They would love to hear from you. And if you want more videos like this one, make sure to subscribe and then ring the bell to get notified when I post a new video every Friday. My piece of advice for this week is try not to take the everyday things for granted, including a wire wheel, consumables, anything you use on a daily basis, drinking water. Try not to take it for granted. Remember the people that are there making it and all the hard work that went in behind such things. Remember the little things, appreciate the little things, and remember, learn something every day. We will see you next Friday. Thanks for watching.